Gaming is a fun hobby that is now widely accepted as a mainstream activity. Because of how many people are now taking up gaming, the variety of games being produced is endless. Many players from the past are considered to be hardcore gamers and stick to their favorite game or genre, whether that's single-player masterpieces or MOBA games. A lot of these players end up wanting to play professionally as well. So in this video, we are going to talk about the video games you can beat in one day. The video is going to be amazing, so make sure you stick to the end. Undertale. The modern cult classic developed by Toby Fox, Undertale redefined storytelling for games of its genre. With the classic pixel art RPG style of the past, combined with a bullet hell mechanic in terms of battle, Undertale changes the way most turn-based battling takes place. The game can be played in a couple of ways. Players can either choose to be a pacifist and not kill anybody throughout the game for a clean heroic run, or choose the genocidal path and slaughter every creature in the realm for a villainous turn instead. Each path taken can lead to different endings, giving the game a lot of replay value. Both of these paths also reveal different bits of vital information necessary to piecing together the story and finding out what has led to the present circumstances. Drake's Deception. The Uncharted franchise, with its iconic protagonist, Nathan Drake, is a classic PlayStation series. Famous for its engaging storytelling and compelling character work, Uncharted 3 just kicks it up a notch with its fast-paced gameplay and quick decision-making. This has led to a fun, albeit brief, experience just the way we like it. Even though Uncharted 3 is usually the forgotten child of the series with the other, more popular entries like Uncharted 2, Among Thieves and Uncharted 4, A Thief's End, it is no less fun in terms of gameplay. Vastly improving everything from the second game, such as graphics, gameplay, and quick-time event sequences, Uncharted 3 is an experience that is second to none, with a story that will leave players wanting more. Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. With a name like Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons, you would think that this game would be all about cooperative multiplayer gameplay, but it's a single-player experience. The objective of the game is to guide two boys across a serene fantasy land as they seek out a cure for their dying father's sickness. Brothers put a spin on traditional puzzle platforming by incorporating some interesting mechanics that you have to control both boys at the same time, with one map to each thumbstick on the controller. Nearly every action you make involves combining the brothers' efforts, be it crossing a raging river or just traversing the many obstacles throughout the strange fairy tale land. Before we move on, support us by hitting subscribe and the bell icon to get notified when we post new videos. Now, let's get back to our topic. Transistor. Making use of an isometric viewpoint, Transistor lets players take control of the character Red as she travels through a series of locations in a mythical world and battles enemies known collectively as The Process. The game benefits from an extremely polished and somewhat complex combat system that incorporates both real-time and turn-based aspects. Battles aren't merely just mashing buttons and using abilities. You'll need to do some mental computations to deliver the right combination of abilities to take down foes with efficiency. Aside from the excellent combat, the great thing about Transistor is that your weapon is a talking sword that you develop a sentimental attachment to. It supports you both in battle and emotionally, pulling you into the tragedy that befell the city and revealing a searing story you'll feel compelled to see to its conclusion. Shovel Knight. Shovel Knight is a modern version of those retro, pixelated, side-scrolling video games. The platformer sees players take on the role of the Shovel Knight with his trusty shovel, using it to clear puzzles and defeat bosses. It has become a bit of a cult classic since its release in 2014. Speedrunners had an absolute blast with it. Those who don't want to rush their playthrough will still get it done quickly, taking around 10 hours to beat. Mirror's Edge. Mirror's Edge was a first-person shooter that changed the game. Players could run through its entirety without ever using a gun or simply going all out with the available weapons. The Parker-based game takes 12 hours to beat with every objective finished, but a short 6 hours for just the main story. The world is fantastic, the mechanics are incredible, and it has influenced titles like Dying Light and Titanfall. Gone Home. It's a dark and stormy night, and you come home from being abroad to find that no one is there. Little clues are left around the house as to what happened to your parents and younger sister. You can explore the house at your own leisurely pace and as thoroughly as you like to figure out why no one is home. Gone Home is by no means a horror story, although the premise sounds like it involves spooks and scares. This game is more of a coming-of-age story, and you're putting the pieces left by your family to find out what it all means. So that's it. Please like, share, and comment with your thoughts below if you liked this video. Remember to subscribe to see our next video. Stay safe, and we will be back soon with another video.